Okay, good afternoon. This is Mr. Rongan once again. So now let's look at lecture 6 in proposal writing. So in today's lecture, we are going to look at cost management, which is a very important aspect of project planning and also management. So perhaps we would like to look at the objectives of this lesson. So at the end of this lecture, people, you must be able to understand the importance of project cost management. You must be able to explain the basic project cost management principles, concepts, and the terms. You must be able to discuss different types of cost estimate and methods of planning. So now let's begin with what is cost and project cost management. Cost is a resource sacrificed or foregone to achieve a specific objective or something given up in exchange. That's what we call the cost in simple terms. Basically, costs are usually measured in monetary units, such as dollars, or in kwacha, or in other currencies. Now, what about project cost management? What is it? This includes the process required to ensure that the project is completed within an approved budget. So now when you come up with the budget, you must ensure that you stick to the budget as you execute your project. Otherwise, then your costing is very bad. So now let's look at the project cost management process. The first one is cost estimating. That is developing an approximation or estimate of the cost of the resources needed to complete a project. That's what we call cost estimation. So we come up with an approximate estimate of all the resources that you need to complete a project. Then there's also cost budgeting. That is allocating the overall cost estimate to individual work items to establish a baseline for measuring performance. There's also cost control, which is controlling the changes to the project budget. You know, a budget is a work, okay, on the paper. So as you start doing the work, you must find that there'll be some changes here and there, but you must be able to push on those changes. If you have done that, you have actually proceeded now to control the cost. So remember, there's cost estimating, cost budget, and cost control. Want to remember these things very well, just triple C. Okay. Now, what are the basic principles of cost management? Remember, most managers of executive board have a better understanding and are more interested in financial terms than other items. So project managers must speak their language. They only understand these financial terms very well, such as profit, okay, the life cycle costing, and the cash flow analysis. Okay, these are the terms they have to understand and we have to stress as we do the costing and the feedback to the executive. Okay, so now, what are the types of costs? Okay, we've got tangible costs. Okay, these are costs or benefits that an organization can easily measure in dollars or in other currencies. Those are called tangible costs. Then intangible costs are costs or benefits that are difficult to measure in monetary terms. What about direct costs? These are the costs that can be directly related to producing the product and service. So all the activities that heads the production of a particular service or product, you call them direct cost. The opposite of cost is indirect, which are the costs that are not directly related to the production of a particular service or any product. They are indirect costs. They are incurred as you do something, okay? As you do other activities, okay? As you do the activities throughout the project, you also incur other costs. Those are called indirect costs. And there's also a sunk cost. again, which is the money that has been spent in the past, is called the sunk cost, which of course, okay, when dealing with the project, invest, continue, you should not include the sunk cost. Don't include them, because they are done already. So if you include them, you might produce a realistic project cost plan. So let's now look at the cost estimation. Project managers must take cost estimation seriously if they want to complete projects within budget constraints. That point has to stick. It is important to know that the types of cost estimate and how to prepare cost estimate and the typical problems associated with project cost estimate. Very important to know these points. So then what are the types of cost estimate? We have the what you call GROM, rough order of magnitude. So this is done very early in the project life cycle, often 3 to 5 years before project completion. Why is it done? It provides estimate of cost for selection details, and accuracy is very good because you sit way before the actual activity, you plan well in advance before you commence activity. So again, easily monitor everything and make adjustments and make a projection of 3 to 5 years, even more, how things will be on the market. And there's also budgetary, which is, okay, which takes a shorter period in terms of when you should do it. Look at when you should do it, it's just 1 to 2 years out. Again, it puts the dollars in the budget plan. Okay, so the budgetary cost estimate is done, okay, shortly before you commence the project, as opposed to rough order of magnitude, which is done way back before you even start doing the project. And there's also definitive cost estimate, later in the project, less than 1 year out. So basically, as you are doing the project, you'll be estimating what to do next. Okay, the next activity cost how much? Achieve one activity. Okay, to go to next, how much do we need? That is called definitive cost estimate. Right? So as you are doing the project, you're able to come up with the cost of the project. Yes, this one, it might give you what you want and do the work successfully, but the accuracy are also very low. So you can see these three types of estimate: the rough order of magnitude, the budgetary, and the definitive. The question is, which one of these do you prefer or do you use as you are doing the cost estimate? You find that most of the people who use option number 3, definitive. As we do the project, we'll be estimating what we need to do to have next. This is very, very common people. That's why projects, sometimes they stall, because if you don't understand what you need to do next, you find that it will take time as opposed to just cutting through, okay, cutting the work easily from the start up to the end smoothly. Okay, so this diagram shows the accuracy and the ranges, the pre-launch, the launch, and the execution of the plan and their accuracy levels. Okay. Cost management plan, what is it? It's a document that describes how the organization manage cost variances in project. You find that large percent of total project costs are often labor costs. So project managers must develop and track estimates for the labor. Here, you must be very, very clear. Many people, they don't include labor. So they will only cost what is needed, but they'll ignore labor. You find that people will be demotivated as they're doing the work because they're not cluttered for terms of labor. And in that way, you find that many people shun the projects. It's either project stalls, or it's abandoned, or it takes very long. Remember, when the project takes very long, the cost goes up. So don't forget to include the labor cost. So this table shows an example of the cost management, okay, and what is needed for a project manager come up with a better cost management plan. So a large percent of cost of many projects are human resource cost. So as you can see, if you break it down in this way, but you know that, okay, a lot of cost goes to human resources, which is very, very true. If you look at all these others, you find that the cost of these things is not so much. But if you look at where human resources are concerned, you discover that you need to pay a lot. So information systems, marketing systems, reservation, and the contractors, you find that they actually need so much. Cost estimation of tools and techniques. What are the basic tools and techniques for cost estimation? We've got top-down estimate, got bottom-up estimate, parametric modeling, and computerized modeling. So the top-down estimate is where you actually look at the previous project, similar projects that you have done before, and adopt the new technique in the current system. So you break it down. And then the bottom-up involves estimating individual work items or activities and summing them to get a project. So you break down, then you aggregate all these, then you come up with the total, which is very, very true for most of the projects that you do. That's how it costs to use bottom-up most of the time. The parametric modeling uses the project characteristics in a mathematical model to estimate project. So you have to come up with an empirical formula that will help you to estimate. Just punching the figures, you find that that algorithm is going to help you to do the project. Now things have become so easy for the computer. You will use tools such as spreadsheet and other software packages that can estimate this for you. That as we will learn in the project software management, we will learn how to do all this costing just by the click of the button without difficulties. There's also COCOMO, the constructive cost model, very, very important, and it actually helps so many project managers to cost their projects without difficulties. COCOMO was introduced or developed by Barry Beam, who was actually a software engineer specialized in project management. So if you run through, you find that this is a software that can actually help many end users to appreciate and do the cost planning without difficulties. Typical problems with cost estimate. One, developing an estimate for a large project is a complex task that requires significant amount of efforts. Must take it so seriously. People develop estimates often do not have much experience. Interesting, that's very true. Human beings are biased towards underestimation. Find that every time you underestimate, no one will overestimate. Even making a budget at home, you'll be underestimating. You won't be overestimating. So this is the problem. Management might ask for an estimate, but really, a desire, okay, to win a major contract or get internal funding is actually there. So, both of these people miss impact. Cost budgeting. Cost budgeting involves allocating the project cost estimate to individual work items over time. So the WBS is required, okay, is a required input for the cost budgeting process because it defines the work items. So you need the breakdown for you to come up with the project. So that's why before you cost anything, have a work breakdown structure. Important goal is to produce the cost baseline, okay, the one that you have on the paper, which won't suffer or which won't be exposed changes on the ground. It's a baseline cost. So a time phase budget that project managers use to measure and monitor cost performance. Cost control. Project cost control includes monitoring cost performance, ensuring that only appropriate project changes are included in a revised cost basis. Informing project stakeholders of authorized changes to the project that will affect cost. So many organizations around the globe have problems with cost control because of what we have seen there on the job. Therefore, using software to assist in cost management can help to sort out some of those problems that are looked at in those cost testing methods. Spreadsheets are the most common tool for resource planning, cost estimation, cost budgeting, and cost control. Many companies use more sophisticated and centralized financial applications, software for cost estimation, just to solve those issues that you are dealing with. So project management software has many cost-related features, especially the enterprise project management software. So to summarize, we are saying project cost management is additionally a weak area in project, and most managers must work to improve their ability to deliver projects within approved budget. Many processes include cost estimate, cost budgeting, and cost control. People, as we reflect on what you have discussed, remember, most projects, they do fail because of lack of cost management. So please, I encourage you to go through the lecture once again so you can master the principles of cost management and able to apply them even in your daily activities as we endeavor to do bigger projects in the future. So, people, this is how far you can go. See you next time.